Well, it's intermission time here at the Spectrum, fans, and you think I'm tall at 6'5". This is tall. 7 feet four and 380 pounds of the very favorite.
480 pounds.
Huh? Four, did I say 200? 480 pounds. Of, who's going to quarrel with him? Andre the Giant, who's returning to Philadelphia on the Spectrum after about 3 or 4 months, as I recall. He was in a Mammoth Tag Team event some while back, and now he's just returned from Australia and New Zealand, where he's wrestled in Japan also. Andre the Giant, glad to welcome you back to the Spectrum again. You're going against Hulk Hogan tonight.
Yeah, and I want to say one thing first. I'm very happy to come back here. It's very nice to be back in Philadelphia, and tonight that'd be for the first time in my life, I go to have a top match, and I know that.
Well, this guy is... Excuse me.
Go ahead.
No, I'll excuse myself to you.
Because that guy, he never lost a match, but I never lost a match either. But I have to say one thing. I've been wrestling for 15 years, and I never lost a match. That guy is in the wrestling just for us, I think, 3 or 4 years. I know he gets some good matches. He beat lots of guys. And he never wrestled against a big guy before. So I know I got an advantage in my way, because I wrestled a big guy before. When I first came in USA, for me, it was the first time I wrestled against some big guys like Killer Kowalski, Don Leo, Jonathan, Ernie Ladd. And that time they give me a real tough time, but I still beat him. And now this guy comes is the biggest after me. He's the biggest guy in the wrestling.
Well, I interviewed him a few months back, Andre, and he's about, let's see, you're about 180 pounds heavier than he is. He weighs in around 300 pounds, so you're going to have your work cut out for you. But on the other hand, I think he's going to have his work cut out, because I don't know, has anybody ever lifted you and body slammed you?
No. And I know he would have tried to do it, but just like I said before, that guy has everything to win, because if he beat me tonight, he's going to be the first one who defeat the Giant.
All right. Now, we just said earlier when we came on that you returned from a very successful wrestling tour of Japan, from New Zealand, and also Australia. How do you like the Japanese wrestlers? How do you feel they match up against perhaps yourself and also the wrestlers whom you wrestle?
Oh, they're a good wrestler. You know, it's not the first time I go to Japan. I wrestled against Inoki, Sakaguchi, and they are really good ones. But Sakaguchi used to be in the Japanese champion in judo. He was in the Olympics and all that. It was really good. And, of course, Antonio Inoki. They are really good wrestlers, too. But they don't give it a hard time like I go to have tonight.
Well, let me ask you this. You know, these guys weigh pretty much, what, 280, maybe 260, 270. But how do they match up as far as style goes? Do you have a tough time handling them, do you?
Who, those are Japanese guys?
Yeah, yeah.
No, that's okay, you know. Because those guys, they are good wrestlers, but they know the way I'm wrestling, too. So when I got in the ring, they know I got to beat them anytime I want.
Without trying to divulge, if you know at all, a secret as to how a guy might beat you, would it be to get you on the... You know, everybody has trouble. Whoever's wrestled you ever has always had trouble getting you down, if they ever have. Is that the secret to beating Andre the Giant?
But first, they have to put me down.
All right, we were talking before we went on about how a guy this size, 7 feet, more than 7 feet tall, and of course, 380 pounds, 380. I've got 380 on the brain. But he's close to 500 pounds. And he said, how do you do when you travel? He said, I just go first class, and it's very comfortable for me. And he apparently has enough leg room. What's an average day? What do you like to eat, or what's your kind of a diet every day?
I don't have any diet. I love to eat. You know, I'm French, and I love to eat. I love to eat good food. But I don't eat too much in one time, because I like to enjoy my food. I don't want to be full. So I eat sometimes 4 or 5 times a day.
Well, how would you start off the day eating?
But that just is a good breakfast, you know, 16 eggs and bacon, and I eat some steak in the morning too, because I love steak.
How much do you work out during the day or during the week? How often do you work out?
Well, I don't work that much, because I'm wrestling almost every night. See, and sometimes I get trouble to go to the gym, because when I go to the gym, everybody's after me, and I don't enjoy to be in the gym, you know. So that's why, just like before I got here, I was in the dressing room, and we work out in the dressing room.
Do you have much trouble going from one city to another, adjusting from one restaurant to another?
No, because I'm traveling like this for the last 15 years, and I still love
it. Doesn't bother you now?
Not at all.
Our pleasure to have as our guest tonight, obviously, a very popular young guy, young because even though he's been around 15 years, he's young enough to still take the knocks and bangs and all the roughness of wrestling. He travels a lot, as he said. I said, where are you going after you leave here? He says, I don't know. He said, I go wherever the wrestling takes me. So the guy just wrestles anybody and everybody to keep himself interested in wrestling. So we've been talking to Andre the Giant tonight. After the intermission period tonight, he goes up against the Incredible Hulk. Hulk Hogan, he said he's going to take him. We'll find out before very long whether or not he does or not. So this is all from Dick Graham at ringside of the Spectrum and our great guy tonight, the adversary of Hulk Hogan, Andre the Giant.
Dick Whirly say?
He said Dick Whirly referred to his wife being here tonight.
Uh-huh.
And we have Hulk Hogan. There he is, a good ringside shot of him. Here he is laughing into the crowd. Indicating his superiority.
Well, he's in for the night of his life, isn't he? With Andre the Giant.
Well, going to be interesting. Here's a guy, 6'8", I believe, 300 pounds, roughly. My last interview with him, he told me he was down from 320 to 305 because of all the travel. And we've got Andre the Giant, who, during our interview, if you're watching a few minutes ago, said he's 480 pounds.
Loves to eat. And loves to eat.
Loves to eat.
And eats
that.
Four or five times a day, right? What do you have for breakfast? 16 eggs,
he didn't
right?
say he loved to eat to be a pig about it. He says he likes to eat because he enjoys eating.
Right.
Oh, mercy.
Is that Hulk Hogan's fiance?
I believe so.
Yes.
Maybe our camera guy can get a shot across
could,
the ring.
Yeah.
Here he comes.
Well, they're on Andre the Giant.
Here comes the Giant himself. There he is. Look at this guy right above us. Look at this guy.
Hulk
steps
talking
over.
To him, introducing
Everybody
himself.
Else steps through the ropes. He steps over the ropes. Funny. Oh, fans,
here
it is tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a special bonus match this evening. It is set for one fall with a one-hour time limit. Introducing in the corner
Rodman.
To my left, from Venice Beach, California, 321 pounds, the fabulous Hulk Hogan. And wrestling fans, his opponent this evening, from the French Alps, 475 pounds, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant.
I started to say, Rudman, if these two guys, either or both, start coming in this direction, I'm leaving. You're going to finish the top.
I'll do the match for you. Nothing bothers
me. I'm leaving town.
I'll get Gary Petetta to throw his famed left hook again.
All right, getting last-minute instructions. Okay. Third guy in the ring will be... staring one another. Get the action here. Watch this, fan.
Yeah, looks like Larry Holmes and Muhammad Ali. Huh? Uh-huh. Intimidation time. Ain't funny, McGee.
Hey. Hogan's got to be saying, what did I do now? You know, what... Why did I do this?
Well, guess who's boss?
Hey, Whirly, what's he going to say? Please, Andre, would you back off?
Please, sir. I think we need Gorilla Monsoon in here to referee.
Oh, wouldn't that be? Hey, will the ring hold these three guys? Hair pull.
Please. Be nice. Play nice, boys. That's the least he's going to have to worry about is a hair pull.
Andre says...
Oh.
Hogan's going to know he's been against it tonight. It's not over yet, fans. You don't know how it's going to go. But...
I don't know. I can read Andre's eyes, and he isn't worried one bit. Would you be?
Nah. What's the worry?
Yeah, what's the worry?
He's such a beautiful guy. We were talking before the interview began tonight. He's just a very soft-spoken big guy.
Oh, 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 make a wish. Oh!
Hogan grabbed for the ropes, man. Wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? And, there's a playful slap at Hulk Hogan by Andre. The kids love this guy. They just love him.
Oh, yeah. They really do love him.
Yeah, they really love him. There's a side headlock by Hulk Hogan, who's laughing a little bit. Or is he laughing to cover up the tears? I don't know.
What did Andre say? He has 16 eggs in the morning.
Has 16 eggs in the morning. And steak sometimes in the morning.
He loves steak.
Loves
steak.
All right, the fans will... fans just cooling to wait to see what happens. It's early yet.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. Hold it, Nelly.
Whoa,
no
baby.
Way. You don't run into brick walls, do you?
Hogan says, oops. I'll tell you, though, seriously, I've never seen two bigger guys in the same squared circle. I remember the night Andre wrestled, what, three guys?
Yeah.
In a tag team match. You can hear Andre letting out the as he gets kicked and kneed.
But Andre's going to come right back. But he seems vulnerable there in the abdomen, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Oh, he picked him up, trying to.
Picked him up, as I said earlier.
Yeah.
I asked, as you saw the interview at intermission, I said, Andre, have you ever been body slammed? He says, nope.
Uh-oh, it looks like a suplex. He's going to do a suplex on him.
Whoa!
Oh.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
But Andre's on the floor and is vulnerable.
Yes.
Except Hulk.
But there.
From whom?
Oh, he slammed down on Hulk Hogan. Hogan wiggled out of that. Came down on his shoulder. This is the best. This is the best Hogan's going to have it with this guy.
Oh.
300 pounds. Yeah. He just picked him up and tossed him. Nobody's ever done that.
Yeah, Hogan couldn't believe it. Well, he's got him down on a mat. They're both equal down on a mat.
Yeah. All right, there's a choke hold. The count of three. Referee Worley indicates that Hulk Hogan has to break it. And he does. Slam to the back of the neck area. Another slam. Forearm smash. Oh. Andre just doesn't know his own strength. And this guy's trying to lift him. All Andre's got to do is relax. He'll get a hernia trying to lift him.
Well, he's hurting him with the bear hug.
Yeah, to some degree.
Yeah.
You know, you look at a guy like Andre, and you expect him to be totally invincible, but there must be some areas where he can be hurt badly.
Oh, there is an Achilles heel.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, you saw the blows to the abdomen did affect him.
Yeah. I think the fans are starting to chant now. They're starting to build it up. They want Andre to put this guy away. And well, he may.
Well, Andre's getting ready to counter. Headbutt. I think the worst thing he can do is hurt Andre. Because Andre may just decide to get him out of there.
Well, they got to break it now against the ropes. Yeah. Depends how, though. That whole ring. Oh, did you see that ring there? Andre comes back with a fire.
Bear hugging.
Hulk Hogan's trying to bear hug, but I'm watching his fingers there. His arms encircle the body of Andre, but the fingers are just barely holding on. He doesn't really have a firm grip. He may have pressure added to him, but. Andre almost put him in the upper deck with that. He's favoring his back, though. He's been taking a pretty fair beating with that. The bear hug. Andre's a little bit upset now. I think he's a little bit mad about this.
close. I think he's going to finish him. Andre's beautifully coordinated, isn't he? He played soccer.
Oh! Body slamming 300 pounds, man. You just saw it. Fix him up like a wing of a chicken or a drumstick. Here we go! This is where he excels, his sheer weight and height, driving the opponent.
Yeah, he's softening him up. Oh!
Uh-oh, here we go. Dick Worley's out. Dick Worley's out on the mat right now.
I don't know what we can do for Dick.
Well, you can't do anything for him right now. He's in the ring and we're not.
Yeah.
But Hulk Hogan's outside the ring on the other side. Worley's not even... Yeah. He's trying to indicate the bell.
Andre wasn't aware of what happened.
Andre says...
I'm really concerned.
Look at that. Look at it.
Oh. Very good.
The tender giant helps the referee to his feet.
Yeah.
There's Hulk Hogan indicating he's number one on the other side of the ring. But actually, we've got to wait for the official decision by what actually happened here. Dick Worley indicated the bell ought to be rung because he was out of it. He felt he really couldn't honestly continue. That's the way it seemed to be. But we'll find out now as we get the official decision from Gary Capetta, the ring announcer. As we say, Hulk Hogan outside the ring, the giant inside the ring waiting for the announcement.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 7 minutes, 23 seconds, Hulk Hogan has been disqualified. Your winner, Andre the Giant.
Yeah, Hogan pulled Dick Worley right in between him. They're kidding around there now, Worley and Andre the Giant. As Hulk Hogan threatens.
Hogan can't take this.
He can't take it. He's posturing.
No way.
All right, Andre.
Andre says he's number one. Hogan better get going if he wants to live to play another day.
He's waving his finger. That's about all he's going to wave.
Andre says,
come on in.
Back.
Hogan has no intention. None whatsoever.
Hogan.
No way.
Right.
You know what? I think you're talking too much and you're not doing anything. So come back in that thing. I'm going to show you what it is.
All right.
Okay. Andre's an upfront guy.
All right. Let's watch the action on your screen, fans. Here we go, the instant replay of the events leading up to the decision. There's Hulk Hogan being smashed, jammed into the ring corner by Andre. Here he comes, over the top rope, and he's leaving. And here Andre continues to punish Hulk Hogan. He swings into the corner, and then Dick Worley's pulled into the middle between the two men. He crashes the floor, and that's the leading up to the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, because of the unusual...